Ho, 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 and Merry Christmas, everybody. This week is the final Christmas special here on Kraaft It Live, and I'm just really glad that you've decided to join us. And if I move my head to the wrong place, the hat's going to come off. So we're just going to try to get through this the best we can. I've got really sticky fingers because there's a lot of glue involved today. And of course, we're using napkins. So I just wanted to let you know that this has been a fabulous time for me this December. Doing the Kraaft It Live show during December has been a big deal. It's the first time I've ever done it. I usually take this whole month off. If you've heard me say that before, I'm sorry, I'm repeating myself, but I want to make sure that those who are new understand that this is a big deal to me because I never get to do this, but it's been wonderful because it makes me get up out of bed, and I don't know if you can tell or not, but I'm doing better. And I'm not alone. I've got my wonderful Sylvia with me, and I'm going to say hi to Sylvia and let her say hi to you.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the third installment of the Christmas special. And like she said, this is so exciting because she always took the month of December off. And be honest with you, I hated it because I need my Heather fix and I didn't have
I hated
my Heather
it. Fix. Oh, man, if I heard that before.
Yeah, and other people didn't like it either that she was leaving us. So, you know, she claims that she needs some R&R. I don't understand that. It's not as though she doesn't have enough to do, okay? But anyways, I want to say welcome to our guests that we have today. We've got Nanette and Jazzy, who's Jane. We have Vicky. Hi, Vicky, just joined us. And Lon and Belinda and Claret. Hi, Claret. And Haley and Orla, BJ and Lucy. We're so glad that you guys are here with us. And I'm going to put up the devotional and some of the comments that have been going on. Let me get today's message up there. Today's message, oh, that the entire world's saving grace is packed in a fragile little baby. She gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger. That's Luke 2, verse 7. I love that verse.
Me too.
And then here's another one. This is from Haley. Oh, yeah, it's Crafty Tuesday, doing the crafty dance. I can just see you doing that, Haley. And this is from Clarette. Okay, we're having a gorgeous day here in Ohio, so sunny, like our group. Oh, how sweet, Clarette. And I just have to add to that, my daughter was visiting for this past week. She was here for a whole week. The whole time she was here, we did not have blue skies, and we had very cold weather. And I felt so bad for her. And now she's going back to Ohio, and thank God she gets to see some sunny skies. So that's great. Thank you, Clarette.
Oh, are you ready for me now?
Yes, I'm ready for you now.
All right, I'm looking for something with color on it to
okay, take me off. You got me on. Take me off, lady.
Yes, ma'am. Oh, my word. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Okay. Let's see. Let's use this. See if that'll help. It's going to be all reds and greens, though, but please adjust. Please adjust. I'm begging you to adjust. It's not adjusting. Okay, how about, I don't know why, but the camera has not been very positive lately. It's not been a good experience. Okay, we're just gonna go with that. And if it doesn't look right, we'll fix it as we go. Okay, so I have lots of fun things planned for you. It's going to be mostly us messing around with stuff and seeing what we can come up with. The idea for today's show is to make as many memories as you can for the holidays, because I feel like the holiday time gets filled with too much running around and too much stuff to do, and people don't take time to actually make memories anymore. I remember sitting around with my cousins and talking about memories and making them, and that kind of clued me into, hey, we don't do that stuff anymore, you know? So let's do some of that. So here's what I've got. I went and bought a box of 14 glass ornaments. These are the kind when you drop them and they shatter into a billion pieces and it feels like it's going to kill somebody. These you want to be very careful with. So if you've got older kids, this would be a great project for them. Little kids might not enjoy it too much, but we're just going to take one of these white ones, and I'm going to remove No, I think I'm going to leave the cap on this because I think that'll be good to hold on to. And yeah. It's pretty secure. So I think I'm going to leave it. The other ones that I tried, this was not very secure. So taking it off was kind of crucial. But then I'm also going to put on my gloves. And if you're like Sylvia, what? I've not seen you wear gloves before.
Yeah, this was kind of surprising to me. I've never seen her put on her surgical gloves. Ooh.
It's really not easy for me either with this wrist issue, but I got it. Okay, so the reason I'm wearing the gloves is because I'm going to be doing a lot of glue today. And you know what happens when you get glue on your fingers once? You have glue on your fingers for the rest of the day. And it messes with every project you do. So I figured, you know, on the gloves is one thing, on the hands is another. Okay, so I've got these great little napkins. And they'll make some wonderful Christmas presents or Christmas ornaments, I think, because they're very Christmassy. But what if I don't have Christmas napkins? What if all I have is something like this? I've already chopped it up into squares, and so I'm going to remove the extra. You've seen me do this too many times. And this particular one happens to be only one layer, so this works great. But the reason why I wanted to do this is because this bulb is white, so when this goes on there, it'll be really, really good. It'll look really pretty. But what we're going to do, Sylvia and I learned, we want to paper piece this. So we're going to tear it into smaller pieces, and that'll kind of lose that pattern a little, but that's okay, we don't mind. So I'm just going to tear some of these. So this is something you can do with, if you've got some lady friends you want to go hang out with for your holiday. You know, sometimes we do like those cookie exchanges. Have you ever done anything like that with your friends?
Yeah, that's always fun.
I have too many cookies. So I'd rather have like a ornament making party or something of that nature. But you could do this with the ladies from church. And you
well,
know what?
I a Christmas card making party one time too in the community. Remember, Heather?
Oh yeah, we did. Yeah. We sent each other parts and pieces to make a card. That was fun.
That was fun.
All right. So these are pretty much inch and a half, probably, size. And I've got a sponge brush because, you know, I like to throw it away and not have to worry about keeping it clean. And I'm going to start by just applying some to the glass. It's kind of a thin layer. I don't know if you can see that. It's very thin. So when I add the napkin, of course, the napkin will sort of disappear. Now, if you put too much on, it will disintegrate the napkin. I've experienced this the hard way. So the key is to not put too much on. And then overlap and go to town. So here we go. Don't worry about those. Some edges are torn and some aren't. Don't worry about that. You just cover up the not torn with the torn, and you won't even see it really.
And paper piecing like this is so pretty.
Yeah, and you think about you're really more focused on the color than you are the pattern per se, because you see how the pattern kind of disappears. It's not really, the pattern isn't really the key to this. The coloring is. So in this case, we have got this pretty blue, like a baby blue, almost the color of my gloves.
Yes. And they're wondering how long the gloves are going to last, too. They've made comments about that.
Well, you'll see.
Yeah, I think they'll stay on because, oh my gosh, you know how that's like when you get all that glue on your fingers and it's, nasty stuff.
Unfortunately, the gloves are going to last just fine. It's whether the gloves are going to be covered in tissue or not is the key. Because that I think we're going to find. All right, so here we go. Just gently going around.
Andrew is saying the gloves will go in about 5 minutes. 5-1 odds, people.
I love it. Give me some of that action there, Andrew. Oh, that's too funny. So the key to this is little bits and pieces and a little bit of glue at a time. Now, I'm using Finnebear Soft Gloss Gel. I chose gloss because I want it to really be more like glass when it's dry. And that gloss will, you know, make you feel that way when you look at it, that it will have the impression that it is glass, even though we know for a fact it's glass. But you could do this with something else. We'll show you that in a bit. These are fairly small too. These are not gigantic bulbs, so it's really simple to get it covered quite quickly. So you can actually get a few of these done. And while they're drying, you could have your eggnog or, you know, whatever beverage you like, and maybe even those cookies if you really are into having more cookies. I just feel, 1 year I went to 7 different cookie exchanges in one season. That was not a fun thing. Okay, now here, I went over that particular part a little too much and it kind of tore the napkin, but that's okay because I can just go over it with another piece of napkin and you'll never even see that that was there. You might not even really see it there, not, you know, being on camera. I'm having such a hard time with that left hand. It's very difficult for me to grasp with my thumb anymore. And that is painful. All right. So even though I didn't put any glue on the bulb right here, I'm going through it, through the napkin with it, so it's adhering it.
Andrew's wondering if you could do this with styrofoam balls. Hold on, Andrew.
Yeah, please hold that thought. We'll get right back to that one in a minute.
And then Belinda was saying the gloves always become a part of whatever she's working on. and I think you almost had that today, too, because your gloves stuck to something.
Yeah, I was kind of panicking. We were doing some tests because we wanted to see if like spray adhesive would work. And it works to glue the napkin to it, but it does not work to overlap. So you get kind of a, you know, an icky mess is what you get. And yeah, I was sticking to that ball, wasn't I?
Yeah.
That was crazy. But just trying to figure out what's the best way to achieve this. Now, while I'm doing this, I'm thinking of something. I wonder what happens when I drop this one. I said when, because almost inevitably these always drop, but what happens if you drop this particular bulb now that it's glued together like this? Will it last a little bit better than the other ones? I'm curious.
Well, I think because it's glued together, it will. I don't think it'll shatter.
So there, you got your cheap little bulbs that, you know, always seem to break every year that you can turn into something even prettier, and maybe it'll stay and not break at all. I don't know. All right, one more little spot I see that I want to cover up right here.
I love the overlap look. I've always liked that look. I think it's very pretty, and particularly with the napkins because they're so see-through, you get to pick up what's underneath it. So.
Yeah, it's almost like an overlap with it's just like that layering like we do in our art journals. That's what it's really like.
Yeah, Belinda says she thinks it'll last better too. And Orla said she found some napkins with a world map on it and one with ponies. I think you can find napkins that just about got everything on them anymore.
Okay, so there we go. This is my first one. And of course, you want to think ahead and have a place to hang it so it can dry. Because if you set it down, whatever it's sitting on, it's going to glue to. You could use wax paper, but I'm afraid that the wax paper will pull off the napkins. So you want to hang these. And I happen to have a spot over here that you can't see where I'm hanging them. Being very careful. Don't swing around. That makes me nervous. Okay. All right. So now here's one that we did.
This is so pretty.
And I'm going to make myself a mess here. Okay. So this is one that we did earlier. And we added, what is that? Glitter?
Glitter.
We sprinkled glitter on top. Can you see what it is?
I know what it is. Do you guys?
I know you know,
but
are they able to? I wonder if they're able to see the pattern at all.
Okay. Can you guys see that?
So here, of course, they're going to start typing, and I'm going to tell them what it is by the time they.
Okay. Now let's just wait. Let's wait and see. We got people typing.
Okay. I'm over here getting some stuff anyway, so.
Okay. Andrew said that with those glass ornaments, if it dropped, it might be look like an egg. You know how a dropped egg's got the cracks?
Oh, good point. Yeah.
Yeah, like, that might be kind of cool.
Let's throw one and find out. All right, so.
Okay, they're guessing. Yay! Yay!
Do they know what it is? They know what
yeah,
it is?
Yeah.
Okay, so I took this particular napkin here, and once we open it up, we see two beautiful full-size poinsettias and a wonderful frame around the whole thing. And what I did was I tore the frame, much like we did with this, and put that around much of the area to cover up the background part. But then this, I cut out the center part here, all one piece. And that's what you see in the front there. That's all one piece. And then these little parts here I put on first. So you want to do your background with the edging, then these parts here and there all over, and then this center part over the top. Now I did that with both of these, and we ended up with the poinsettia on both sides, and you can see all of that. Then when it's still wet, we took Martha Stewart's extra fine crystal glitter, and we just sprinkled it over the heck of that. And now we have this beautiful glistening ball that's ready to go. Now, here's the key point, though, what I wanted to show you, and we're going to do it with this one over here, is we started with a styrofoam ball, Andrew.
There you go.
And so these are kid friendly. You can have some good fun with this and not worry about the kiddos too much. Some tricks we're going to go over here. It's the exact same thing as what we saw with the glass one, but this might be a little bit easier for the kids. So I've got this kind of busy. We did learn two things. When you have a kind of busy pattern like this, or like this one, it, look at that. Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah, it's very pretty.
You can tear it apart and use it on your styrofoam ball or your glass ball, either one, much easier than a specific patterned one like this. All that white space, all that, when it just doesn't play very well. That's why I cut them out. But I wasn't going to make you watch me cut it out. So let's tear some of these.
Do you want to separate it first before you tear it? Because you had to separate each little piece for afterwards.
You're so right. I do. And thank you for telling me before I got too far involved here. But I did learn one thing about separating napkins. If you cut it or separate it like, you know, tear it like I just did, it separates easier from the center than it does from the machined pressed edge. So if you're able to do... cut them in half or cut off a corner or something like that, you'll be able to get at the layers a little easier. It still gets harsh with some of these better napkins. They do just really want to be together. I was going to have this one separated. Remember that?
So yeah. Yeah. Well, we lost track of time. But I like that because you actually show the frustration that so many of us feel.
Uh-huh, yeah. Okay, so are there any comments? Because I'm going to struggle with this one a little while.
They're just going, go for it, and the poinsettia is very pretty. And prior to the show, they were talking about wrapping Christmas presents and what they're going to do and some ideas that they had. That was kind of cute.
Well, I've never really talked about this publicly, so I'll talk about some of our family traditions here because, you know, like I said, we always disappear in December, so we never really have a chance to talk about it. But one thing that we've done for years and years in my home is we focus on giving only one gift. Each of the kids can have one gift, and we do that because we want to focus on the one gift that we were all given this time of year. So that's what we do in our home. But now that there's grandbabies, it's a lot harder for this grandma to be only one gifting. I found so many things for Miss Kay. She just cracks me up. She absolutely loves clothes. She's 3 years old and loves clothes.
Uh-huh.
I've never, ever met a kid like that. This napkin has driven me insane.
Andrew's saying, wad it up and then unwad it, and maybe it'll come apart better.
This one right here is already done.
Okay, there you go. Through the magic of TV. Okay.
Uh-huh. All right, so what we're going to do with this one is rip it up.
And Lucy was saying that, and Lucy's here for the very first time, too. So we want to give
Lucy.
We're gonna do kudos to Lucy. Thank you.
I'm grateful that you joined us. Always happy to see new faces.
And she said, this is such a great idea. It's perfect to give new life to old baubles, too. I think I'm going to have to try this.
That was a great idea, too, is that I've seen a lot of people redoing their trees completely. Like, the in thing now is to do, like a color scheme. And what do you do with all those other balls that you've had, or bulbs, or however you say that? What do you do with all those if you're going to go out and buy all new ones?
Yeah.
I've seen so many people doing that too, and it's frustrating because there's stuff to be had. You know, we've got things in our closets. So what do you do? Well, here's the thing. You could make them all match. You could have one package of napkins, probably do your whole tree. Okay. I have some craft wire here. This is just like jewelry wire. I think it's cheap. At Walmart stuff. You know me and my Walmart. I can find everything in my Walmart. Okay, so it's really thin. Really thin wire. So I have to double, quadruple it up. And I'm making myself a little handle to hold on to. And because it's styrofoam, I can just do that. And I don't have to worry about this hole, because I'll show you what we'll do with this in a little while. But the key, again, is little bits of glue, not a lot of glue. And this is why you want the gloves, because you got to make sure that this sticks. Because it's styrofoam, it reacts differently than that glass did, obviously. But you don't want to go over it too much, because if you do, that will disintegrate the napkin and you'll end up with mush. So that's what we're going to do as much as we can before we move on to the next idea that I had. And you want to make sure you overlap. And here's one tip that I also learned in this whole thing, which was start at the top and work your way around and then down. Otherwise, you end up with gaps that you're trying to fill in later. And that's when you can really make a mess, because you'll have to go over it again. And every time you go over the napkin, you risk it getting gooey. So you just want to continue with it all the way around. And we're not going to do this whole one, because that's just silly. Watch me do that all this hour. Come on. We got other stuff we want to make. Okay, so you would do that, overlapping it all the way until the entire thing is covered. And of course, through the magic of television or YouTube, we have one that's finished. And we used this napkin here and created this bulb here.
Isn't that pretty?
I don't know if you can see it. I've got to figure out which way is the best way to show you this. But see, notice where everywhere it was white, it see-through almost. So if you like that, that's good. If you don't, then cover it up with some more of the other parts. So the more white on your napkin, the more you're going to have that. And I really liked it. I like the contrast between the red and the green and then the white every so often. And plus, where it overlapped, you can't even really see very much. So quite nice. And then we did sprinkle this one with a little bit of glitter, not nearly as much as I think I would have liked to, but while it was still wet, because it's still wet from all of that gluing, sprinkle on top.
Everybody likes that one, Heather. They like the I think it's a cardinal.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, they like
that.
Yeah,
I don't know what kind of bird it is, because I'm
not a
bird.
Cardinal? Okay.
I have no idea. I'm saying I don't know birds. But
it doesn't really look like a cardinal, but it's
a
red bird.
But it does in there.
Yeah, it's a red bird. We like it.
Yeah, so there's that, and that is really pretty, and it's very glossy looking. It looks wet almost, but it's dry.
Really?
It's wet looking because we used gloss gel. So it really, it doesn't look like styrofoam anymore. It took the cheapness away from it. So what we're going to do is I'm going to hang this one up over here. I'll get to finishing it later off screen.
Very pretty. Maybe.
I didn't make my loop big enough to hang it. Lovely. We'll just put you over there at that hanger. Okay, so what I'm going to do is put these aside because we are going to use them to finish that one eventually. So how would I finish this off? This is dry, and I'm going to pull this out. So now I have just the ball, right? And I've got my, I can take these off for a minute. So you want to see how long they're going to last? They're going to last the whole show, people. I promise. Where did I put the ribbon? Here it is. So I've just got a couple of cheap ribbons that I have had in my stash forever, but I think I buy these at Walmart or Dollar Store or wherever I can find cheap ribbon. I never really look at ribbon too closely. You can spend a lot of money on ribbon if you really want to.
But... yeah, you can.
Okay, we're going to just cut off probably foot and a half of this. You can never have too much ribbon, so don't feel like you're wasting it. That's why I buy the cheap stuff, because it doesn't kill me. I know some people freak out. Ah, there's, you know, a centimeter you took in the trash. One item that I did not take out of the bag, which I hope is still in the bag. Oh, good. Phew. Are these things. You don't need these things.
Oh, stick pins.
Yeah, these, the pearlized pearl heads, whatever, that adds a nice decorative touch so you don't feel like you're having to hide something. So I'm just going to take one of these and notice I have the ribbon is kind of like together. I think we're going to go this way. And where's my hole? I can't even really see it. So we're just going to push that napkin down on top of it, what was sticking out. I'm going to lay this over and then put my pin right through it. But I don't want to go through that same hole because that same hole was much bigger than this. Yeah, I missed it. Good. So there we go. And now you can use this as your hanging ribbon. And I like using a dark green because it'll get lost on the tree. I like that. That's almost look like it's floating instead of.
I thought you were going to go down and around and tie it up on the top.
Oh, no. Sorry.
Make a cage.
You could do that. You do that on yours.
Okay. All right.
And then make sure you post pictures in the community so we can all see it.
I will.
All right. And then I'm going to tie a bow because that's what I do. Tie a bow with this. Like that, trim this, trim that, and I'm not done yet. Now I'm going to make a bow right here and without pulling the pin out. So you just want to not put too much force on what you're pulling here. And probably, depending on your children that are doing this project with you, if you're doing this with kids, probably 8, 10 could handle this without too much grief. I've noticed it really depends on the kiddo, so don't try comparing yours. Like if you've got an 8-year-old who can't do this, don't get upset. And then I want to leave that long. I want to leave those red ends long. So when it hangs like that.
Oh, that's so pretty. Look how pretty that is. Aww.
So it looks like it's much more than, you know, a styrofoam ball. It looks like a lot more, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
And you can, of course, make your bows a lot prettier. Now, I have this other half of the napkin. So this was for the ball. And then now I have the other half of the napkin. What am I going to do with that? Well, here's the next project idea. See these gift boxes. Have you ever seen these in the store? They come in all different sizes, and you get, they're just plain white. And this particular one is perfect for holding, you guessed it, an ornament. I have zero strength in this hand. That's just crazy. Okay, here we go. All right, so this is how these boxes come. You get six boxes, and they have the box and the lid. So we're going to take the box, one lid, set the rest aside for later. Okay, and you've got, this is how it goes together. You just open that part up, open this part up. And then you can put some tissue in the bottom and put your ball in there, and your ornament right there is good to go, okay? But that's kind of boring. White box, boring. So let's flatten it back out. Sure. All right, flatten her back out and flatten this back out. And we're going to decorate our lid with that really pretty part right here. Now, I am not going to separate the napkin first because we found that using the scissors, cutting that edge helped with separating them, but I really hope I don't have the kind of problem I had with that little one. So I'm just using, this is particular to this napkin. You want to use whatever. If there's no focal point on the napkin, then don't, you know, you can make one. You could cut out an individual bird or the jingle bells or just slap a piece on there. It doesn't really matter.
Haley shared with us that she makes light bulb hot air balloon ornaments. How cute is that?
Okay, light bulb. Say it again.
Light bulb. You know, your light bulb, your incandescent light bulb. Hot air balloon ornaments.
Oh my gosh, so the light bulb, the right side up. So the bottom is the basket. Oh, yeah. I want to see pictures, Haley. Pictures.
You're required. Post them in the community, Haley. That sounds so cute.
Yeah, you're required to share that with us.
Don't mention something. The same way, you know.
Don't mention something if you don't want to share it with us. I'm sorry. What were you saying?
She says she makes them the same way that you're doing them. You know, doing it with a napkin.
That is so cool. I love that idea.
She says she will. She'll post.
All right. I might steal that idea. Oh, I should have said that after you posted the picture. Come on.
She said she'll post them when we're done here. Woohoo!
Okay. All right. Looking forward to it. That's going to be exciting. Come on.
That's for people who can still buy the incandescent light bulbs, you know? I mean, they're trying to get rid of them and go with the LED ones or whatever, you know?
Oh, you can find them at Walmart.
Oh, cool.
Forever.
Forever.
Now you can find the CFL or whatever they're called in that bulb shape.
Oh, okay.
They're very expensive, though. Like, ridiculously expensive.
Well, I guess rather than throwing them away, it's like, save them! You can make ornaments.
Yeah, used ones. Yeah, your used ones, exactly. Okay, so this is going to go right up on here, see?
Isn't that pretty?
Oh, gloves. Where are the gloves? I'm using the gloves today because no matter what I'm doing with this glue, because man, howdy, I do not like having to clean that junk off. Normally, it does not bother me too much because I don't do this much gluing and touching. But when it comes to doing this show, I don't really think too much while I'm doing stuff. And I tend to really regret that later.
Apparently, there was such a demand for her her ornaments that broke into a fist fight at one of the exchanges that she went to. Oh my gosh.
That sounds terrible, but hilarious.
Yeah.
Tell no one I laugh.
Oh my gosh, that's great. And Andrew says there's a difference between stealing and unauthorized borrowing. Really?
Yeah, it's using those particular words. That's why. Okay, let's see. Now I'm just going to make sure I put an entire coat of the gloss all over this lid, all over the top of this lid. Now here's something. If you don't like to see brush strokes, you don't want to use a brush like this. These sponge brushes are terrible. But I like to be able to throw them away and not have to worry about ruining any of my brushes. I've ruined a lot of brushes, and I no longer have the brush that I set aside specifically for this product because I never put it in the water. Okay, so once it's dry, it'll have much more like a plasticky finish to it.
That's you could such also a clever way to do to decorate a box. I love it.
I know, it's like 50 cents, less than 50 cents for this box. And you just add a little bit of napkin to it. It matches the thing that's inside. Very pretty. And they can store it this way when they, you know, put it in their Christmas ornament box. Okay, so you can also take your ribbon and you could go around. If you're worried about that unfinished edge, you could go around it with that. You could doodle on it. But it's wet, so we're not going to right now. But... And I don't have one of these finished ahead of time. I didn't do that. But
that's okay. Beth Brown's joining us. She just got here. So hi, Beth.
Hi, Beth. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do with this. I'm going to chop this one in half. And I'm not too worried about it being perfect or not. I don't really care. I'm going to make the edges better when I doodle and stuff like that after it's dry. I'll post pictures, of course, but... Maybe I'll do a blog post. I have not done a blog post yet this month. Maybe I'll do a blog post that'll explain what I do at the end, but I doubt it. I'm just going to be honest. Okay, these are not, they don't want to come undone. I don't understand. I almost wish I would have done it. So see where I'm going with this? It's like four panels, right?
Yeah, so pretty. I just think napkins are so frail, but then when you doing what you're doing and you can see that they don't want to pull apart, they're pretty tough.
Oh, they're tough until they get wet. It reminds me of some people I know, but you know, we'll just leave that go. All right, here. There's where it gets very fragile right there. You got to gently pull that apart, even if it doesn't want you to. All right, so we'll do that, and then we'll do this one on the other side. Yeah. And then that leaves us with half of one here. And we'll put that on the other side as well. Those are off by a little bit, but we don't care. It doesn't need to be perfect. It just needs to be done. Oh, that one is almost, look at, I just ripped it. Uh-oh. No, it's going to last the whole show. I mean it to. These are not meant to go off and on your hand over and over again. Okay. Same concept. Just put your glue down. And I'm trying to do a thin coat because really I just want this thing to stick to it, and then I will make it, you know, the kind of plasticky finish.
Yeah. That's okay. So cute. That's such a clever way of doing things.
That's the bottom of the box. So do it like that. I mean, think about this. You could get some really nice gifts done for if you've got any last minute gifts that you forgot about, or if you have neighbors that you exchange with, but you don't really want to spend a lot of money, but you want them to know that you think of them. This is kind of cool because you spend a little bit of time that really messing with the napkin is the most time, it seems like, and then drying. Okay. And again, you don't want to go over it too many times. Just like with the ball, it will snag. Very cool, right?
Yeah, it's gorgeous.
And then I'll put these on this side over here. We'll leave it for now, but you get the idea. The bird and the thing on that side. This on the top. And then the matching. I'm going to lay this down like this. The matching ball inside in some tissue. And you have quite a nice gift.
It
really was
pretty
simple. Okay, so that's that idea. You need to dry over here so you don't get stuck to anything. Okay, so now you've got the kids, you've got different age groups that you've done the glass ones with, the styrofoam ones with. What about the little ones? The little ones want to play too, especially because they get into seeing what everybody's playing with and they want to grab this and start touching each other with it. But you don't want them to do that. So what you're going to do is you can cut circles out of different things. You could find something that makes any size or shape. The bigger the better, I think, because little hands like bigger things. So take something that's round and trace it onto some cardstock, or use a die if you have one, or your electric cutter and cut out an ornament shape if you have that ability to do that. I have these in a couple of different colors that I've had for the last couple of years. Now I've got, it's just thin cardstock, so we're gonna use a couple. And there's two things you can do here, depending on the age of the kiddos that you're with, or if you're doing this yourself. Glue these together using the same process as we've done, so you have a thicker, almost chipboard-like thing. And then you can cover this with your napkin, just like we've been doing, same concept. Add a rub on or whatever and it's good to go. Or give this to the kiddos with some colored pencils or something and let them have some fun with it if they're too little for the glue. You can give stamps if they're old enough to use stamps and just have them go to town with it. What if you don't have this kind of a die or electric cutter? Okay, then let's put that aside and let's grab a piece of trash. I have like these things that come out of it's quite thick and it has kind of a glossy finish to it too. Okay, so we're going to use, this is just a round thing I have sitting here. It happens to be the next step to the next process I want to do, but you can use anything that's round, a mug, whatever. And we're going to get a Sharpie marker or some other black marker. And we're going to go around the edge. Oh, and we're going to scream as my thumb goes haywire on me. Oh my gosh, the pain. I'm so sorry. Okay. Okay, there we go. All right, then you just want to cut that out. And it helps if you cut on the inside of the line because then that black line won't be seen. And this part you might want to do ahead of time if the kids are too little and they don't have patience for you. Have these done ahead of time, and it's not that big of a deal. You could also use plastic lids, like if you have, what are they called? I almost said Tupperware, but you wouldn't use your Tupperware lids. The, like, butter dishes and things that come, like sour cream and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Save those lids. Save the backs of paper. Whatever. And you have, and it doesn't have to be perfect because this is for the kiddos. Remember that, okay? So this is the part you want to do ahead of time because you want these to be dry for them. You're going to use your gesso. And you're going to slap some gesso on there. And all you're trying to do is get rid of that glossy finish. It might be that you're using cardboard and you want to give them a white finish so that way they can actually draw on it or color on it without any issues. But this particular one, I don't want there to be a glossy finish. So just, now the more times I go over it, the more paint I'm going to take off, or gesso I'm going to take off. So we'll just leave it like that. Hit it with the heat tool kind of quickly. Gesso dries so quickly that it's not, there's no need to panic about it being, you know, too much ahead of time. It's not like you need to do these a week before everybody comes over, you know. Are there any comments?
Yeah, well, that's, you know, drying and stuff. I just want to say that Andrew just, he really loves, you know, the fact that you used that box and made the ornament and stuff. You know, he says, a cheap box, a napkin, and a lump of coal. I love it. You know, yeah. And that's so true. Yeah, and I mean, it just is so beautiful what you can do with inexpensive items. And then he's saying, okay, do peanut butter lids work too? Yes, Andrew, you can use your peanut butter lids. That would work.
Oh, I love you, Andrew.
And then Lon noticed, look, Ma, no gloves. But yeah. That's gesso. That's not quite
it's
the
gesso,
same thing,
not, not glue. I can gesso my hands anytime I want, but glue, that's different. All right, so what this does, this gesso will just give us a good finish. For those of you who are new to gesso, gesso is, what does Dina Wakely call it? Underwear for paint? That's what she calls it. It is a primer. That's the bottom line. It's a primer. It's going to make a smooth surface rougher. It's going to make a non-porous, glossy surface able to hold on to stuff, just like primer would. So there, that's still a little wet, so I just rubbed some off, but that's okay. We don't care. This is a really simple way to do things. So now you could, again, use your napkins, which I don't seem to have any more that are already torn apart. Here, this one. You could use your napkin and put your napkin on there. You'd want to do both sides, of course, because then as it spins. So you could glue your napkin on there, and then that gesso underneath will act like white cardstock, and you'll be able to see all the detail of this beautiful napkin. And then I think we talked about this before. If you missed it before, we in another episode, once this is dried on, you just use your emery board and you can file the edge right off. You don't have to trim it. So see how simple that is? One half of a napkin there, put in between, boom, hole punch, ribbon, done. Or for the kiddos, get out your... You know me, I like my cheap Crayola markers, especially when the kids are over. So you could do just about anything you want here. And kids can do whatever they want. Don't tell them what they need to draw. If they're asking for questions, tell them to, what does Rudolph's nose look like? You know, maybe you actually want to make this like one of them glass balls. So you could even use watercolors.
The kids are so free with their imagination. They're not stifled. And so they'll just come up with some great, great ideas there.
Chances are they don't want to hear your suggestions anyway. They want to just be allowed to play. Because to be honest with you, the world is too filled with too many do this and do that's. And remember, we're making memories. We're not trying to make anything perfect. The whole point of this entire episode is to get away from the hustle and bustle and the... There's a ridiculously pronounced version of the perfect Christmas that everybody seems to be trying to attain, and there's no reason for that, trying to achieve. There's really no reason for that. Nobody wants it, to be honest with you. Ask your family. They'll tell you, we don't care. So here, this is my Christmas bulb. Me coloring a big circle red. Yeah, that's what you tuned in for.
Well, BJ made a cute observation. She says, adults want to make things perfect. Kids just enjoy and have fun. And that's so true.
Yeah, and I almost feel like saying, you know what, let's take this back, adults. Let's say it's our turn to enjoy as well. And you know, stop worrying about making things perfect, because honestly, nobody wants it. I really mean it. Nobody even noticed the fact that you didn't have the whatever on the tree at the right time. Or okay, so there's my ball. I would do the same thing on the other side, of course. And then you just need a hole punch. So really simple. That's not a hole punch you want, though. I have a little teeny tiny hole punch. Oh, boy. I've yet to use this guy.
And like Belinda said, too, she says that's so true about kids. They teach us so much. They do. We just have to stop and listen. We have to allow ourselves to hear them.
That's it exactly. That is truly it exactly. Okay.
And BJ says she has 9 grandchildren. Woo!
So she probably gets the lesson quite a bit.
I think Nanette has a lot of grandchildren too, don't you, Nanette? What's your number?
Yeah, why don't you guys all tell us about your family that you have?
Yeah.
And let us know if you're getting to spend time with them these holiday time or not. And this is really fun if you use paper twine. What is this stuff called? I don't even know what it's called. Raffia?
Raffia, yeah.
If you use this, then it looks even more handmade. Like you need any help with that area. But make sure they put their names on it and the year.
Yeah.
Here's what's absolutely really funny. You guys saw that thing that's hanging behind me on the backdrop, mm-hmm, with the handprints. T-Dog was down here yesterday and says, oh, this is really cool. Mom, did you make this on your show? I said, no, take a look at the name and the date on it, bud. And he did. And he goes, I did this? So there you go. So there's a kid version of the same concept, right?
Yep.
Just have some fun with them and make them memories. Well, we
got some good conversations going over here. Nanette says she's got 27 grandchildren.
Woohoo!
Wow. And I want to put this comment up. This is from Christian, and this is so true. Oh, my gosh. I'm in an adult coloring group, and some of the folks who share are perfect, perfect color, perfect blending, etc. However, that's kept others who aren't perfect, and they won't share. And that's so true.
Isn't that crazy? Okay, so this is something that we strive for in the crafters community. We do not compare. We do not say things like, well, some people have said it, but we always tend to like correct them. We do not say things like, you guys are so good and I'll never be. We don't allow that. Because it's not about being better than anybody ever. I'm putting my gloves on. That's what I'm struggling with here.
And Andrew's made an astute statement. He says, I'll put that up too. He says, this is cute. Children should be heard, H-E-A-R-D, and not herded. And that's so true, Andrew.
Okay, I had to get a new glove because...
you tore it?
Well, I tore it putting it on the bad wrist, bad hand.
And everybody's talking about their Christmases, and BJ says that everybody's coming for Christmas, and the art table in the toy room will be a busy place. Oh, that's
good.
Exciting. That is so cool. And Belinda's saying all 4 of my children are coming and all my grandchildren, so it'll be happy times.
Very cool. Okay, so the same concept goes with things like chipboard, okay? Go to your stash, because we all have a stash of stuff. Go to your stash and find your chipboard. Even though this is a square and it's not at all Christmassy, you can paint that with the gesso, or you can add a napkin, any of that kind of stuff. Think about, you know, these are pink flower-shaped funky things, but they have a hole in them. You add a napkin to this, voila. All of this kind of stuff. And then, of course, there's Christmassy stuff. I have these chipboard ornament things from my days gone by. And there's trees and gingerbread and all that kind of fun stuff. But those are pretty much, you expect that to be Christmassy. So I'm not going to do anything with those, because you guys know that's what to do with it, obvious Christmas things. But I do want to do this because I think this is going to be fun. These are very old, but they're in my stash. So we're going to use them up. Yay!
Yay!
And I've got the gloves on, so we're gluing again.
And Andrew said, yay, told you, you're going to lose the gloves, and took a little longer than 5 minutes, which it did.
Yeah, it did take a little longer than 5 minutes, and I only lost one. So really, you lost. You lost your bet. That's the bottom line. Okay, so a little bit of glue on that end. We're going to tear Santa in half here. Gently, Santa, you're going to tear in half. Santa, no, I'm going to scissors it.
Yeah, I can just see it going right across his face.
Yeah, me too. That's why I chose not to.
And everybody's saying nice things about the community, you know, that's one of the reasons they joined our community, because everybody's so helpful and so caring, and it's really a great community. It sure is.
It is. And I pay each and every one of those people to say those things.
Like Christian said, she said, that's why I come here, because, you know, there's no expectations. It's just a wonderful, caring, loving community.
That's the reason why I keep coming back. I mean, I never could have dreamed to have made such a thing, honestly. I'm very honored every time somebody gives me the credit, but really it's the people within it. So it's just a great place to be. I love it. It's my favorite place on the internet, my absolute favorite place on the internet. All right, so I've avoided that top part up there and put the napkin on both sides and just kind of spreading it out. Thank you, gloves, that you allow me to do this. Okay, now with it wet, it's kind of a pain, so we're going to dry it. Forgive me.
It's okay.
These ones are really nice to do when you have a specific image on your napkin, you know, something you want to keep, like the Santa. I mean, he's like an old world Santa, so that's really going to be nice ornament when it's done. Oh, you know what I forgot to mention? I sent out the newsletter this week, and I did a little testing, kind of a trick little thing on my newsletter to see if anybody reads the whole thing. And those who have done what I asked of them and have been entered to win it's kind of a crazy prize package. It's the things that I've made in these three episodes. Actually, it's not just that. It's a couple of other things that I've made that are Christmassy, but it's basically Christmas art is what the winner is going to get. And not very many people are entered. So it kind of proves just how little the newsletter gets read totally. So if you did enter, you have a pretty good chance of winning. And if you didn't enter, or if you're wondering what the heck I'm even talking about, take a look at your newsletter mail, your newsletter, and read it, and you'll find out what I'm talking about. And if you're not yet a subscriber, you'll want to click the subscribe button down below on this webpage if you're watching on the website. And if you're not watching on the website, you're watching on YouTube. You just go to the website, kraaftshaak.com, and you'll find it at the very bottom of every page on the website has the subscribe button. Okay, so I'm just using my emery board to just lightly sand that edge. It gives me such a perfect edge without having to worry about it ripping or, you know, being perfect with your trimming or any of that kind of stuff. So much easier.
I just want to mention that Lucy apparently was playing along, and she said, woohoo, I just created a styrofoam bauble. Instagram it. So she's going to Instagram it.
Oh, yay. Perfect. That's
excellent.
Perfect.
Yeah. Be sure and you post it in the community too, Lucy.
Yeah. And I think she's actually on the list for being approved. So she's waiting for that, I think.
Okay. All right. We'll get you approved.
Okay. So I have what is this called? Ink.
Archival ink.
I have that, and I have a sponge here. Let's see. Yeah. Oh, goodness.
Okay, it's not going to happen. There you go.
Okay, so I'm just going to use my inking tool here and sponge these edges. Now, I know this is specific to a product that I own, because I own this little chipboard shape and everything, but it's pretty normal. It's a normal thing you can get anywhere, but just wait till you see the second piece. You're going to be really mad that you don't have this, I know, but It's not, it, what I'm saying is use what's in your stash, and this is in my stash, so we're using it. Don't have to go out and buy new things. I really love the idea of using your old Christmas ornaments and redoing those with napkins. I think that's genius.
Yeah, that's for sure.
All right, so somebody asking yet about what to do about this part up here?
Yes, what are you going to do about that top up there?
I'm so glad you asked, Sylvia. I'm going to get out my embossing powder. Okay, so let's see. I have Superfine Metallic Gold by Wow. And I have my Versamark whatever. And now I can take my gloves off because we're done gluing. And I think we're done gluing for the entire show, actually. Okay, so scratch piece of paper, got my Versamark ink, and I'm just going to use the pad and apply Versamark ink. And we'll do the other side here. Look at that. That's going to be really cool. Let's heat tool. I'm going to use the industrial strength one, the super loud noisy one, because it will heat it faster.
Okay, while it's drying, I just want to let you know that Haley posted the pictures of her hot air balloon over in the community, so that's cool.
Yeah.
When you're all done here, everybody can go over and look, you know, but not now. And then Lucy said her Instagram name. She's got it in the comments.
Oh, hold on. I'm gonna mute so you can say what you need to say.
Okay, that's okay. And then Andrew said that he's frantically searching his old emails for that newsletter. That's cool. And everybody's excited to see about this embossing, so that's going to be really cool. And Lucy, I promise after show I'll get you into the community ASAP. Wow, that looks pretty.
Okay, now I'm not done with the embossing, but I am done with the gold. So let me put that aside for just a second, because what I want to show you is, remember that round thing that I used as my shape maker?
And I just want to say that we're 5 minutes after the hour.
No way, really?
Yeah, we are.
Oh my gosh, my clock is way wrong. It says I still have, oh, okay. All right, well, let me finish this and we'll be all done. This is the last piece. So sorry I kept everybody. I didn't mean to. All right, so what I had already done half of this in embossing powder, and now I'm going to do the other half for you here. Remember, your embossing powder can go on to even your chipboard pieces, so don't forget that when you're making stuff. And this is beautiful embossing powder. I wish I sold this one in the store because...
it's a pretty red.
Yeah, it's tinsel. It's red embossing tinsel. From Ranger. Yeah, and I mean, it is like glitter stuck to it, so you know, you get the effect of glitter without it getting in your eyeball. We all like that. And then it just turns into this solid piece of shimmeriness. And you'll want to do two of these. I'm only going to do one so we can say goodbye, but. Now there's two things you can do here. You can glue it directly on. Look at that.
Oh, is that pretty?
Can you see it?
Oh, wow.
What a difference that makes, huh? I mean, yes. that is a tremendous, and this is just chipboard, and it looks like a pretty amazing ornament.
Oh, wow.
So you can glue it directly on, or you could actually use foam tape around the outside edge so that it's kind of offset a little bit, allowing somewhat of a shadow under there. We're going to glue it directly on. And we're going to use Tombow Monolumin glue.
Sure.
The one that I can never say the right name. Yeah. This one. We're just going to put a bead of glue around that edge so that we can call it done. So now, if you've enjoyed hanging out with me in December, I want to say thank you for coming, because I've really enjoyed doing this. You guys have gotten me well I've gotten healthy because I've had to get up every Tuesday to come see you all. So I appreciate that. And I've got some major, major, major news coming for a huge announcement. The actual, let's see, I'm gonna turn this so the stuff is the way I want it. The actual official announcement is going to be coming out tomorrow, I believe, but I'm gonna let you guys know. And the newsletter peeps already heard this, but Cece and I are going to get together and do a marathon, an artathon live on New Year's Eve. And we are going to be doing that starting at 10 p.m. Eastern. We're going to hit all four time zones in the new year. So come celebrate the new year with us, Cece and I. Look for that announcement in the Crafters community. When? Tomorrow, probably. Sometime tomorrow, I think. Anyway, there you go. So these are our ornaments that we did, and we'll say goodbye.
Everybody is saying thank you so much, and they hate when time is up on the show. And Lucy posted her picture over on Instagram, and as soon as we get you in the community, you can post it there for us to see, Lucy. And thank you all for participating today.
Yeah, and look at the box is almost dry.
Isn't that pretty?
And see, it has kind of like a plasticky finish because we used the gloss. Mm-hmm. I think that turned out pretty good. Where's the other one? I don't know what I did with the other one. Here it is. I'm going to put a ribbon on that too.
Yeah, beautiful.
All right, everybody. Thanks for crafting along this week, this month, this year. Wow, we're almost done with 2015. All right. We have one more special. We have one more special. We have New Year's special next week. So join us next week for New Year's special where we're going to say hello 2016 in a big way.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Bye.